Welcome to this lesson, Mr. Soita. This is social rehabilitation and reintegration. It's one of the units done in social work and community development. That is option A, the social work section. Today, I'm asked to talk about the introduction to social rehabilitation and reintegration. And in this case, we'll have to start with the definition of terms. We'll have to start with defining what rehabilitation is, and also we'll have to define what reintegration is. So when you talk about rehabilitation here refers to the temporary assistance that is given to individuals in the society. Yeah? Remember, this assistance or help is not permanent, but it is just temporary. Yeah? Just to bail out these individuals from the problem that they are going through. So these are activities that are aimed at improving the functional capability of people with functional disorders and their inclusion in the society. So when we bring in the aspect of their inclusion in the society, we are now looking at reintegration. Yeah? So reintegration in this case refers to the assistance that is given to people during their re-entry into the society. We have said that the services offered to them, the rehabilitation services, are temporary. For example, we look at that scenario where we have somebody who does not have maybe one leg. Yeah, but this is somebody who has to be assisted in one way or another. We are not going to fix the leg permanently, but we are going to offer a temporary solution to this, or maybe temporary assistance to this person. We have reintegration. This comes in especially with people who have deviant behaviors, or those who may violate the law of the land. They could be offenders. These are individuals who need now to go back to the community, but sometimes the society or the community may not be willing to accept them back. So what happens is that we as social workers, in this case, we need now to facilitate their re-entry into the society. And we need now to talk to them, maybe counseling these individuals so that they can be in a position to change their behaviors and attitudes and go and talk to the community members so that they can also be willing to accept them back in the society. So by doing that, we have offered rehabilitation and also reintegration services. So these services differ in line maybe with the issue that one is addressing. So we have examples of some of the rehabilitation activities. So before we talk about the examples, let's look at the aims of these rehabilitation and reintegration activities. The first aim is all those rehabilitation services, they aim at getting people back into the society. We have given an example of those ones who have deviant behaviors, those who have violated the law of the society. And some of them may have been either disowned by the community. So they don't want to accept them back. But through rehabilitation and reintegration services, these people will have now to get back into the society where they came from. They also help individuals also resume their functions, or maybe their roles in the society. And finally, all rehabilitation services help people to regain or improve their functional ability, or to improve their ability to function independently. We do not want that scenario whereby they are relying on others for each and everything. So there is something that we can offer to them so that they can do things independently, so that they can walk by themselves, so that they can also be in a position maybe to see by themselves, or maybe handle some of the activities by themselves. Examples of rehabilitation services that we can offer to these individuals. I've said that these services differ depending on the situation that you are addressing. So the first one we have is physiotherapy services. These are services that are offered to help people develop or regain their mobility through physical means. And in this case, we have those professions. These are now the physiotherapists, they are the ones who are involved in treating people of all ages with a variety of physical conditions, for example, injuries to the bones or problems maybe with balance and even coordination. Another example of a rehabilitation service, we have occupational therapy. This one now helps people to take part in all life activities. There are those who find it difficult maybe to perform certain activities, especially in the society. We have the occupational therapists who will have to come in to help people who are having maybe difficulties or trouble doing certain activities due to maybe injuries or maybe some mental health conditions. So they come in to assist those individuals so that they can be in a position to carry out those duties clearly and also independently. Another example of rehabilitation services that can be offered also to these people, we have language pathology. Just as the term states, we have language, or sometimes we also call it what? A speech pathology. So this one now helps people to improve communication difficulties, for example, in reading, in writing, issues to do with the sign language, and also speaking. So we have the language pathologists who are there to offer such kind of services. Remember, these people need to communicate with one another in the society, and they may have some difficulties doing so. So these are the ones who help them to do such kind of activities. We have audiology. So in this case, just as the term states, audiology comes from audio. This pertains now a hearing disability. So we have audiologists who normally assess and also treat and sometimes prevent the hearing loss or maybe hearing disorders. There are people who have those or such kind of disorders. For example, it's not complete, but it could be partial. Yeah. So they come in now to offer some kind of temporary services or rehabilitation services to such individuals so that they can also be able to participate in some of the communal activities. Other rehabilitation services, we have psychotherapy and also counseling. Just like I said, we have quite a number of those services, but it depends now with the problem that one is addressing. So this marks the end of this introductory part, but when we meet now in the next lesson, we'll have to explore more in line with social deviance. So let's meet in the next lesson. Thank you.